Welcome to NonstopNeuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about the home delivery of food and door-to-door garbage collection facility that the blood provides to all the cells in the body. Or in boring words, we will talk about the capillary exchange of nutrients and waste products. Let's get started. In this diagram, at the top, we have capillary. The cells are at the bottom. And in between, we have interstitial space. Before we go into specific details, you must understand the basic nature of exchange first. At the molecular level, it's more of a mixing of capillary and interstitial fluid rather than an exchange. But because of how everything works together, the mixing up results in a net exchange. So what happens is, the cells in our body use nutrients, like glucose and oxygen, for their functions. So the concentration of nutrients is less in their surrounding interstitium. On the other hand, the capillary fluid has a normal level of these nutrients. So during fluid mixing, there is a net movement of nutrients from the capillary to the interstitium. Contrary to this, the activities of the cell produce waste products like carbon dioxide. So the concentration of waste products is high in the interstitium. And the capillary fluid has less waste products. So during mixing up, there is a net movement of waste products from interstitium to capillary. In short, nutrients and waste products are not treated separately. But based on how cells affect their concentration in interstitial fluid, there is either net delivery or net uptake. If this basic is clear to you, now let's see the details about the capillary exchange. The mixing up of fluid occurs mostly by diffusion. Water and water-soluble substances move through the intercellular clefts. The intercellular cleft is a space in between adjacent endothelial cells. Although the clefts take a very small percent of the total surface area of capillary, they are more than enough for rapid diffusion of substances. This is because of the high thermal velocity of molecules in the fluid. Or in simple words, the molecules themselves are moving so enthusiastically that even these small gaps are also more than enough for them. Now, the size of this cleft is 6 to 7 nanometers. The smaller the molecule than this size, the easier it is to pass through. And the larger the size, the harder to pass. Thus, the permeability decreases with increasing molecular size. For example, water molecules being too small can cross readily, so its permeability is 1. Glucose molecules are larger, so its permeability is less than water. Plasma proteins are very large in size, so they have limited permeability. The permeability of albumin is only 0.001. So the concentration of plasma proteins in the interstitium is very low. In a nutshell, diffusion depends on the size of the molecules. Please remember that all this is for an average capillary that is found most commonly in the body. But not all the organs have the same capillaries. In the video on the structure of capillaries, we saw that different organs have different capillary structures based on their specific needs. Like glomerulus in kidneys, have fenestrated capillaries to allow filtration of large quantities of fluid for the formation of urine. And liver has a sinusoidal capillary, which is permeable to even plasma proteins also. Thus, the permeability depends on the type of capillary too. So far, we haven't talked about those guys who have wild cards. It's the lipid-soluble substances. For example, oxygen and carbon dioxide. They can cross the biological membrane, so they can cross the capillary wall from anywhere, including through the endothelial cells. Because of this, their diffusion is far more rapid. Finally, let's see the details of the passage through the interstitium. The interstitium is made up of collagen and proteoglycan filaments with fluid trapped within them. In short, it's a gel-like structure. Because of the large number of filaments, here the fluid cannot flow freely, as it does in open space in the capillary. Rather, it diffuses through the gel. However, this diffusion is also fast enough, and the cells are not too far anyway. So the passage through interstitium is also pretty fast. So this was all about the capillary exchange of nutrients and waste products. Now let's have a quick summary. Capillaries deliver nutrients and collect waste products from the interstitium. This process mainly happens by diffusion. For water and water-soluble substances, the main pathway is intercellular clefts. Lipid-soluble substances can cross the capillary wall from anywhere. The permeability of a substance depends on its molecular size and also type of capillary. In interstitial gel, the fluid diffuses rather than flowing. Now, for sticking with me until the end, here is a bonus point for you. Scattered in the interstitium are small areas of free fluid where proteoglycan filaments are absent. Normally, they contain less than 1% of interstitial fluid. But in edema, these pockets expand, so the percentage of free fluid increases. That's it for this video. If you have come this far, please consider supporting me by liking, commenting, and sharing the video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.